Hi guys, welcome back. Hope you're all well. It's a wet Sunday afternoon, not a lot going on out there in the outside world. It's wet and windy. We're in the garage and I'm just doing a little bit of tinkering, shall we say. Now, there's a lot of talk about suspension out there, in particular GPX suspension being super heavy. I keep hearing this word super heavy suspension on the GPX. So I'm here this afternoon, I'm going to try and dispel a few myths about the GPX suspension in comparison with the WP suspension, which the GPX bikes share, you know, the same design, shall we say. Here on the table we've got two PDS rear shocks, one off my KTM, one off my GPX. We've got a fork leg here which is off my GPX, and I've got one in the vise at the moment, that's off the KTM. So that's a WP unit. WP unit, SZC unit, SZC unit there. So we're going to weigh these items and just see what the see how they compare in weight and what the consensus is. Are they super heavy or not? The first thing that I'm doing is just making sure that in both fork legs they've got the same amount of oiling for one. So the air gap what I use is 110 millimeters, so I've just got the WP unit in at the moment, which is that, so it's going to do the air gap. I've actually just put some oil in and I'll just top it up a little bit more. I've got my air gap gauge here. I've just actually just reprimed the unit itself, so it's got plenty of oil in it. Just get rid of that. Do the next one. So there you go. I've just about got to the end of that. So we've got the right oil level height, or the air gap height. But we'll just put this back together. So that is the WP unit, and you can see it's a WP unit by the markings what are on it. I don't know if you can see that. But the date on this is the 15th of November 2018. Now these forks were actually off my original 2019 TPI bike. You see, they're pretty clean, aren't they? Still in good condition, them. That's because I use protection parts to protect the foot of the fork. So we'll do the same with the SZC fork leg, just make sure the oil level's correct, and then we'll weigh all the components. This is the moment of truth. That's the... Just hang on a minute before we start doing stuff. Just get organised properly so we can see everything on the screen there. Let's try and get that round. So that's zeroed. Right, okay. So let's start with the rear shocks. Now the PDS rear shocks, this is the genuine KTM one. It's a little bit dirty, but you can see it's got the genuine markings on it there. It says the date stamp 26/11/18, so that's off a 2019 TPI bike, EXE. It's got a K-Tech bladder kit on it, and you also tell it's genuine as well by the markings down here. It's got the rebound markings on. That is a genuine WP shock, and you can see all the other markings on it as well on the shock body. The other shock, which is the GPX one, it's made by SZC. There's no markings on the shock body at all that I can see. It's got the same K-Tech bladder kit on it. They're both lowered. These shocks are both lowered as well, so they've both got an internal spacer which stops the shock extending. You can see on the rebound adjusting point, there's no markings on there again, so it just shows you that it is a WP copy clone. In size and shape and everything, they're pretty much identical. There are some very minor internal differences in terms of the diameter of the inner shock body, which is by maybe half a millimeter. That's all. It's nothing, absolutely nothing. So we'll just start with the GPX shock, and this is from the 22 TSE300 up to the 24-25 before the new generation, basically. So that's weighing in at 4.05 kilos. Happy with that? That's the GPX one. Back to zero. We're now weighing in the WP rear shock. Five grams heavier. So they're identical by 5 grams. I would think it's probably a bit of a, might be an anomaly with the scales, I don't know. But so 4.10 kilos on the WP rear shock, PDS rear shock. We'll just reweigh the GPX one again. So yeah, it's in a bit of an anomaly there with the scales. So they're both identical in weight. So we'll move them to one side. Fork leg in the centre of the scale with my hand just not putting any weight on it, but just stopping it falling over. So we've got 4.1 kilos. Remember that one. That's the GPX one. And then we're going to use WP in the same principle. So what's that to 400? Call it, yeah. 4 kilos. That again, just so it stabilises. 4 kilos. So what's? So they're nearly identical. Not far off at all. I mean, you could. Yeah. So there's a slight anomaly in the scales, but again, they're not that far off. They're like 100 grams, 200 grams. I did this experiment ages ago. I'm talking like, I think it was a couple of years ago. And it was about 200 grams then. I'm just reiterating, you know, the suspension is what it is. It's virtually, well, it is a WP copy. However, the only difference with the GPX suspension, which is made by SZC on the WP stuff, internally, there's some thread size differences with things, but the inner rod on the WP is aluminium, on the GPX one it's steel. That is the only fundamental difference, really. So there you go, a small experiment on a Sunday afternoon. Take from it what you want. Back soon, guys.